Hey, welcome to Graphic Policy Delve and GPTV. I'm Brett. Out this week is the latest decades. This is Marvel in the 90s, the Mutant X-Plosion. I mean, what defined Marvel comics during the 90s? That would be the Mutants, X-Men, X-Force, Cable, Deadpool, X-Man. Well, they were all there. X-Factor, Excalibur, a lot of X's. So Marvel is celebrating 80 years, and therefore they've been going through and diving into some of the classics, putting together these trade paperbacks that seem to explore each decade. The trades are kind of a mishmash of issues that try to define the ages. So I just want to kind of go through all the creators that are involved with this. We got written by Alan Davis, Larry Hama, Peter David, Fabian, Nicieza, Scott Lobdell, Jeph Loeb, Joe Kelly, Joe Casey, penciled by Alan Davis, Marc Silvestri, Joe Quesada, Richard Bennett, Chris Bachalo, Steve Skroce, Joe Madureira, Anna Pollina, Ed McGuinness, and Ladronn, inked by Mark Farmer, Dan Green, L. Milgrom, Marc Buckingham, Bud LaRosa, Tim Townsend, Mark Morales, Juan Vlasco, Bob Wiacek, Scott Hanna, Nathan Massengill, and Norman Lee. And then we got color by Glynnis Oliver, Steve Buccellato, Mary Javins, Joe Rosas, Mike Thomas, Chris Leitner, Gloria Vasquez, Electric Canyon, Digital Chameleon, Malibu, lettered by Michael Heisler, Pat Brosseau, Bill Oakley, Richard Stark, and Comic Crafts, Emerson Miranda, Seda Tamafanti and Company, and Steve Dutro. It's a lot of people. So there's a whole bunch of issues in here. And I was a hardcore reader in the 90s. It's when I was in my teenage years. Bought tons of comics. If it was an X comic, I pretty much bought it. And so there was a lot of these that I've read before, and some I actually didn't. But for the most part, I read all of these when they first came out. And it's an interesting mix. You know, I don't know if I agree with all these picks. I probably would have gone with some different ones. But overall, this, I think, gives a good idea as to what was going on during the 90s and what you could expect when it came to the mutants and Marvel. So issues included, we got Excalibur 42, which is a very lighthearted take. We, of course, got Shadowcat and Nightcrawler joining the team. And this is just, it's a fun issue. Wolverine 48 is kind of the reintroduction and refocus on Weapon X. X-Factor 87 is a great issue. This was a team with Havoc and Polaris, a strong guy, and Rain, and Multiple Man. And it has them in front of Doc Samson getting talking about themselves. We learn about them. X-Men 27 dives into Legacy Virus, something that helped define the 90s and the X-Men. Generation X number 4, the school is held hostage, kind of resonates now today, which is kind of interesting. X-Man number 5, character I was never really a big fan of. It's him finding his place in the world. X-Men 328 saw Cyclops versus Sabretooth, kind of something that we've seen so many times, just battle after battle, over the top art. X-Force number 55 has them versus S.H.I.E.L.D. Deadpool number 2, he goes and saves Weasel from Taskmaster, and Cable 64 is yet another origin issue of Cable. Very interesting mix. As I said, overall entertaining, fun to go back and read. It really does kind of give you a feel of what the 90s was like. I would have probably gone with some different issues. I think earlier X-Force would have been better instead of number 55. I think X-Men number 1 helped define that era. I might go with that, you know, especially maybe, or even maybe going with Wolverine getting his adamantium pulled out of him. I think that's all really, really important stuff during that time period. So, and I think X-Men number 1 helped redefine comics as a whole, so I probably would have gone with that one as opposed to maybe some of these other comics. But beyond that, this is a fun trade. It's fun to go back and check this out and see what they think of each era. You know, the art is all over the place, you know, not too shocking. Different series, different styles. Some of the stuff still holds up today. I mean, there's some great, fantastic art in here, so show some of my more favorite items in here. I love this cover, X-Factor. I mean, this one's like etched into my memory. I don't know why this stands out so much to me, but that's a issue that I like remember to this day. And then we get in the more infamous time periods of very varying styles, some of which I wasn't quite a fan of. Yeah, like this one from Uncanny X-Men. I was not really a huge fan of that art style myself. But yeah, I mean, it's kind of all over the place. I probably would have gone with some different issues, maybe some different highlights of the characters. But overall, like, I think it really does do a decent job of showing off the time period and the age and really giving you a good feel as to what things were like. Again, the one thing I would like to see more is an exploration of the time period, a little bit more discussion about these various issues, why they're important, why these various series were important. As is, there's like one essay in it, a couple covers, but I think maybe just a page for each one would have been, would make this so much better and really enhance things. So that's about my one knock with most of these decade things, is while they're decent collections, I don't think they necessarily go into depth as to why these issues are really important and dissect them enough. I would have liked to see that. So this is out now. You can get it for $24.99. It's a great sampling of the time period. So go check it out. It's in comic shops. You can go use our link beneath this video, put in your zip code, tell if a shop's near you. No shop, no problem. We do have some affiliate links, but they're affiliate links, so we get a small percentage, but really you should go support your sites, or the shops, I mean. Speaking of support, I want to thank Marvel for hooking us up with the review copy. We always appreciate it, and thank you for watching. Now, if you're into Marvel, if you're into X-Men, X-Factor, Excalibur, X-Force, X-Man, Deadpool, Cable, I think that's everything. Check us out every single day at Graphic, and comics, and check us out every single day at graphicpolicy.com. We're on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Tumblr, all at Graphic Policy, keeping it nice and consistent. So until next time, keep reading those comics, and keep it geeky. Hey, thanks for watching the previous video from Graphic Policy Television. Just by watching, you help support our site. Thank you so much. Now, if you're watching these videos, you probably care about geeky things like movies, television, comic books, toys, games, video games, you name it. You can go and subscribe right now to our YouTube channel to stay in touch and catch all the new videos, or check out our website at graphicpolicy.com. There's a nice link on this end of the video. But as always, thank you for watching. Keep on rocking and keep it geeky.